Sometimes, on walks like this, the hardest thing could be finding your way out of the station car park to the beginning of the walk. Today I've caught the train from Stratford out to South Woodham Ferrers in Essex. I'm going to walk along the River Crouch. I've been looking forward to doing this for ages, but I'm usually scuppered by the fact they don't run the trains out here on a Sunday, or on a Saturday actually, at the weekends at all. So it's Monday today, it's the 29th of April. It's about midday now. Here we go, look. We're going under an underpass already. We're going to follow the Fern Creek down to the River Crouch. Look, some Iron Age skulls. I imagine they've taken them away now. Now I've got to walk over a level crossing, got to cross the train tracks, which is always a slightly nervy experience, right? One of the reasons I felt inspired to look at this territory for potential walks was after reading Sarah Perry's amazing book, The Essex Serpent. Now, I think that is more the Blackwater estuary than the River Crouch. But it's the other end of this peninsula. We're going to walk along the bottom side of the Dengie Peninsula. And I think the Blackwater is on the northern side. So it's a similar landscape to that book. And it's a real, if you've not read The Essex Serpent by Sarah Perry, I highly recommend it. It's a really magical book. Today's my first walk with a new backpack. I bought a bigger bag because I want to do some multi-day hikes, or sort of, well, a two-dayer really is what I've got planned, and maybe a longer one later in the summer. So just bringing it out today to get it, you know, get used to it. It's an Osprey XOS 38. I got it at a very good price, roughly half price. I'm going to be leading some walks for Waltham Forest Year of London Borough of Culture. It is the first London Borough of Culture, and they've commissioned me to do some walks, which I'm really looking forward to it. The first one is coming up in June, and there'll be a link to book tickets. I'll be putting that on the videos once they go live. Look at my blog, The Lost Byway, for details. And yeah, and also look at London Borough of Culture. It's a strand called Waltham Forest Tours. It's going to be really good. If you're a fan of pylons, you'll be in heaven here. The horizon is absolutely dotted with them. I definitely still need the Ordnance Survey app to help me find my way. I get to places like this where you think, do I go down there? Or do I go down this path here? And this is where the app comes in really handy. It tells me, oh yeah, you've got to take this path. Wow, this is an incredible landscape. I haven't even got to the River Crouch yet. This is still the Fern Creek. The Essex River Board. Seawalls, groins and sluices must not be interfered with or damaged. The penalty is £50. So we're just coming up to the point where the Fern Creek makes its confluence with the River Crouch, which is really the start of the walk. I've spent about an hour just meandering across the fenland here, but it's been really wonderful. So here it is, the River Crouch. Apparently one of the real centres of yachting in Britain. And so begins my walk along the Crouch to Burnham-on-Crouch. really do love being by the water, whether it's a babbling brook or a grand river or along the coast. I've been doing a bit of family history research lately, nothing too complicated, just on a website, and my mother's family were heavily associated with the sea and sailing. Lots of them were in the Royal Navy, various kind of roles. My great-grandfather, Louis Levay, what a name! And his son was called Louis as well. He sadly got torpedoed on a ship during the Second World War. But great-grandfather Louis was a sailor for many years, and then after he left the Royal Navy, he served as a lighthouse keeper in Jersey. Amazing, eh? So maybe, I don't know, maybe it's in my blood somewhere. Really wonderful to be out somewhere which is so alive with wildlife. It's wonderful watching that swan paddle across the mud, and I thought, why doesn't it just fly? And then it took off. Amazing. It's really quite funny. I've just looked on the app to see where I am. It was a little bit confusing, and I was a little bit confused when I was at South Woodham Ferrers. And the reason is, the walk I'd planned to do, that I've had on my list for ages, starts at Northambridge, which is a little bit further along the estuary here. And I got off the train at South Woodham Ferrers because I was convinced in my head that that was a better place to start. Of course, the walk starts at Northambridge for a number of reasons. One is because it's much nearer the river, but somewhere on the journey out here, I convinced myself in my head that it was South Woodham Ferrers where I should start, without reconciling that with the 10-mile walk I'd planned from Northambridge. To be honest, it doesn't make much difference. It means I've got a nicer walk, a longer walk. I think I've got plenty of daylight. It's coming to 2 o'clock. I've got about, I don't know how long I've got to go actually. More than 10, it's 10 miles from Northambridge, but it's funny. See, me and maps and plans don't always go well together. I think one of the reasons that the Essex Ramblers walk starts at Northambridge is, see over there where my finger is, that's where I walked along, and I've had to walk in a big loop. I have to walk up here and then back, and that's the direction I'm going. So it's a massive loop. I'll put a map in here just to show. So it's quite a significant detour, isn't it? So this loop in the river is much bigger than I thought initially. You can see the station is just to the right of my thumb there. I walked down the creek to the crouch here. I walked all the way along the crouch, and I'm currently here. I've got to walk all the way back up, basically not far away from where I was a couple of hours ago at the station, to go around. Oh well, it's all fun and games, eh? That's still where I've got to get to, on the other side there. It's these walks where things don't go slightly to plan, although I suppose I did plan to go off at South Woodham Ferrers, but it was I was looking at a different map. So it looks like I might have to take an even bigger detour as well when I get to Northambridge. Can't go, there's another creek you've got to cross. No bridge. But it's these walks, when things like this happen, that often turn out to be the most rewarding and the most memorable. If and when I eventually get to Burnham on Crouch, this is going to add quite a significant amount of distance onto the walk. But you know, that's what it's all about. see what happens. I have no idea at this stage. This incredible landscape of dried out seaweed, river weed. It's incredible. It smells quite strong as well. It's a nice, freshly painted pump house there. So I finally got to the path on the other side of the creek here that will eventually take me back down to the River Crouch. I still haven't worked out how the hell I'm going to get over to Northambridge though on the other side. I was going to say we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. We probably won't because there isn't a bridge, I don't think. So that's where I was over there to the right when I realised the error that I'd made. Anyway, must turn these things into virtues. Makes it more an adventure, a bigger challenge. You have to navigate my way past some sheep now on this next stretch of the footpath. River Crouch, I think. Certainly up there at the end of this creek. While they're feeding their lamb here on the footpath. You don't see that everywhere. So here is my problem. I need to get across this creek here to carry on along the River Crouch. But I don't think there's any way of crossing it without walking all the way up this creek to the main road inland and going all the way around and back down again. If that's what I have to do, then so be it. So now I've got to kind of walk back on myself again, but going along this creek here and then all the way up towards that pylon in the distance, then come all the way back along the road beyond that marina and then down to the River Crouch. I could have avoided all of that if I'd just stayed in the train for one more stop to Northambridge. It wouldn't have been as fun. Walking is a deeply philosophical affair. Things like, at the moment, I'm having to practice acceptance, for example. I can't change the fact now that I am where I am and that I can't get across that creek. Well, unless you did something really stupid and tried to wade across it, in which case you'd probably get stuck in the mud and then drown if you weren't rescued. You know what I mean? So there's lots of metaphors here, isn't there, for life in general. And that's why when people say, sort of ask me, you know, how do you walk these distances, you know, sometimes I've done long walks, and you think, well, it's actually just in your mind, really. It's just about your mentality. A 5 mile walk can be as taxing as a 20 mile walk, depending on your state of mind. That's what I think, anyway. I'd love to hear what you think on this subject. Obviously, your knees do play a role, but then, even then, managing pain, you know, your knees might hurt. A swan there. Sat regally on her nest. So I've got to go down over this stile and then back over the level crossing, another level crossing. I'll have to work it out from there. I'm hoping there is a footpath that's not on my map that goes along the adjacent to the railway line. But I could be out of luck. You can never feel completely comfortable walking across a level crossing, even in a sleepy little branch line like this. No, it doesn't look like there's any alternative. Looks like I've got to head up to the road and take a big long detour around Northambridge back to the river. So it's completely impractical to try and walk along this B road here because there's just no space to walk really, and the cars are coming along at a furious speed and lots of big lorries and stuff. So rather than get squashed on the road for the sake of trying to save a bit of time, I'm going to take this footpath here, which will take me up to a bigger footpath, and I'm taking an even bigger loop, but I think it's better than getting run over. And it looks delightful, doesn't it? Sometimes you go back to go forward. Let's see, at this stage I'm already taking a massive detour, and I hate walking along those sort of country roads with no footpaths, but that's actually a B road. It's A, dangerous, and B, a bit nerve-wracking. So there is a really big path that runs parallel to the road here, just a little bit further north, and at this stage this walk is not what I thought it was going to be anyway, so I might as well throw in a few field paths as well, hadn't I? Over we go, over this stile. A bit of woodland. So this has the look possibly being like an old track. It may even be an old branch railway line because it sits up on an embankment. Could be the original railway line to Burnham and Southminster. Well, this isn't what I wanted to see. Right away closed due to unsafe structure. Thankfully I think I can go around it down there and up the other side. Yeah, look at this, it's an old bridge, so this must be an old railway. It's the village of Stow Marys over there. Looks like a delightful little hamlet. But I'm not going that way. I'm still going to stick to my original course for as long as is practicable. This is called Stow Marys Holt Nature Reserve. And it is really, really lovely. You never know what you're going to find when you go out for a walk, do you? Here's another old railway bridge over the branch line. So this is Honeypot Lane. It will then take me into Rookery Lane, and that'll take me down to Northambridge and back to the River Crouch. I'm looking forward to sitting down by the river and having a drink and something else to eat, I think, before I push on. I've only got to traverse a very short section of this incredibly busy road, because just over there is the lane that will take me down to Northambridge. Here we go, Rookery Lane. Well, I started the day with a jumper on and my jacket and my scarf, and I have my puffy jacket in this backpack here. It's one of the reasons I bought this big bag today, because I was carrying so many extra layers with me. And now look, down to my t-shirt. What a glorious afternoon it is. I'm not sure the time exactly, it must be between 4 and 4:30. And so I started walking, I think, at midday, and I'm just now about to approach the point that I thought today's walk was going to start before I confused myself on the way here. But it's been a glorious walk so far. And it's still, well, still the walk to do. Well, this makes me glad that I've done the longer walk today. This is amazing along here. Fantastic approach to Northambridge. Could have taken a shortcut down to the river, but I'm coming this way because I think it's the most likely place for me to find food and drink, which I'm really, really looking forward to getting hold of. This is where the station is, and where I thought I would be starting my walk today. In my imagination just now, I saw it as a high street with shops and pubs and things. Looks like I'm out of luck. Well, Nothing so far, so all my hopes of refreshment are pinned on Ferry Road and the ferry boat inn, which I hope takes cards because I've got no cash on me. See, another mistake I made today. It's littered with them. It would appear I have no option but to go into the ferry boat inn. But it's not looking terribly open at the moment. Fingers crossed, guys. Oh, this is quite crushing news. Looks like the ferry boat inn is being refurbished. Bloody hell, what am I going to do? I've got about 2 sips of water left and nothing to eat. I'll be honest with you, I've never been to a village that didn't have a shop. And this is quite a big village, if not a town. I haven't seen a single shop. Looks like it would have been a really nice pub as well. Oh well, I might just have to go and sit by the water and meditate. Very helpful person gave me directions to where I might be able to get a pint. Well, the only place to get food or drink in North Fanbridge. I am going back on myself now. So who knows, this could end up being sort of the end of the walk, or the end of the imagined walk. But I've got to have a sit down and get something to drink. Well, this is impressive. This is where I'm going to hopefully find a drink and a bag of crisps at the Yacht Club. And of course, it closes at 2 o'clock on a Monday. What the hell I do now, I have no idea. So I've done 12 and a half miles to here. That's how much water I have. I don't have any food. And it is, what time is it? 5:30. Sunset is in about 3 hours. Question is, do I just walk for the next 5 miles to Althorne? There really are a lot of boats here. No shop, no pub, but an awful lot of boats. I hate giving up on a walk. And even though I now have no water at all, a bit hungry, I should have done the sensible thing, I guess, was to get the train to Burnham on Crouch and maybe walk back after I've had something to drink and eat. But I just thought, I felt wrong. I felt like I should either give up completely or push on. And I know this is a bit silly, but it's 5 miles to the next train station. So it's a bit of a challenge for me to do this now with no water particularly and nothing to nibble on. Quite unprepared today, as you will have seen. Poorly planned. I normally have some snacks in my bag and some chewing gum and stuff, but of course, new bag. So I'll be all right. This is what it's all about though. Today was all about this view down here along the River Crouch. Now this next bit is going to be quite spectacular. Although today hasn't gone quite as I had planned, I mean, I didn't really plan it very well at all, did I? But you know what? I wouldn't change it for anything. It's been such an amazing walk, and to be here now at this time, it's really, really, it's really magical to be out here now. Sometimes you just gotta spread your wings to the winds of circumstance and see where you end up. So the seawall takes another big meander here as the path leads inland and around the edge of these mudflats. And then eventually in the far distance over there, which you won't be able to see, but I'll pop an arrow on the screen. You see the white smudges on the horizon. That's the next station, the next sort of little town, village, Althorne, I think it's called. Althorne. Walked past miles and miles of these tidal mud flats today. Huge area. It really is an incredible landscape. wish I understood it better. It's odd, you get associations and thoughts when you walk, don't you? You have this experience. It's sometimes sort of passing resonances of former times and other places you've been. And one of the things that comes up as I walk through here is the period when I was living in Australia, in Sydney, on the coast, and we had these, obviously there, looking out across the ocean, vast, vast skies. Makes me think of that a little bit today. Obviously a very, very different landscape. You can see the tide's coming in now. It's coming in really quite quickly. ...16 miles into a walk. What you don't really need is a broken stile. Well, this is interesting. Danger, beware adders. Keep to the footpath. I've never actually seen an adder before. Britain's only poisonous snake. It's interesting, as I was saying earlier, about a lot of walking is in the mind, a lot of it's psychological. And it's funny, when I was approaching North Fanbridge and I could see the shops and the pub, and I thought about getting some food in the shop and sitting by the river, having a couple of cans of beer, something to eat. I was really hungry and really thirsty. It was impossible, the idea that I could carry on without any food or drink. But once I reconciled myself to the fact, well, that was the way things were, and I had to give up or carry on as I am, suddenly I don't feel as thirsty as I did when I actually had water. It's interesting, isn't it? I'm not far away now from I think it's called Althorne, and I feel alright actually, I don't feel too bad at all. And despite being really tired and thirsty and a bit peckish, I've covered the 4 miles so far a lot quicker than I did earlier in the day. That shadow of myself over there on the marshes, it's like I'm being followed by a ghost. Althorne there, just in the near distance, is a fine sight, isn't it? All those glimmering white yachts in the water. That's potentially, or possibly, or most likely going to be the end of the walk there. I have to make plans what to do next, whether to get a train into Burnham. One stop or whether just to head back now. Either way, it's been an absolutely magical experience today. Such a glorious evening. It's the perfect place to be. Out here along the River Crouch. What an amazing old boat, look at that. That's had a romantic past. So I asked the fella back there near the marina where the nearest shop or pub is, and he said, oh, about 50 miles, mate. And in reality, it'll be Burnham. So I think my walk does end here. Whether my journey ends here, whether I get a train to Burnham or to get some food and drink and to have a look around, I'm not sure. It's about 7:30. I've done 17 miles today, which I think is a reasonable walk. I still haven't found the station yet. Wow, what a day. Thank you so much for coming with me. You've been amazing company, as always. And I look forward to seeing you on the next walk. And look out for those my walks I'm doing for the Waltham Forest Borough of Culture.